today we are going to do the crumb tray extension for the We Create machines. I've got it on my 20. This one's going to go on my 40. And I don't know if it's going to fit on the Vista or not. I think it will. But if somebody does it and it works, please comment down below so everybody else knows. What we're going to do is we're going to go to the official We Create group Facebook page. Then we're going to click on the file section. And we're going to scroll down. It's down towards the bottom. And it says Crumb Tray Handle .wws. We're going to click on it. It shows up here on the main page, and where it says File, Crumb Tray Handle version 1, click on it. Your download screen will come up. Click on Open File. And it should come up in We Create Make It. And I haven't done updates, so it's going to tell me I should. I'm not going to. And there it is. Now it's already got the settings in there and everything. I'm going to ungroup this. But it's got the settings in there already for a 20 watt machine. So if you're going to do it on a 40 watt machine, change it, knock it down a little bit. Probably the easiest way to do it is instead of doing a fill engrave, just do line engrave on the wording. Leave it as is, just change it to line engrave. And then for your cuts, knock it down to 2 instead of 3 on all of them. Enhanced cutting left on. And there it is. Alright, so I'm going to put my wood in the machine. I'm going to hit refresh. It's going to show up. It's just a piece of scrap wood that I got. Make sure that it's on there. I'm going to hit autofocus. I'll walk over to the machine and I'm going to make sure that the red dot shows up on the wood. Big piece of wood, so it should be all right. Then once it autofocuses and everything, it'll bring it into clear view and I'll make sure the positioning is still good. And there it is. So it looks good to me. So I'm going to start it, send it to the machine, and we're going to cut it out. Alright, so here it is, cut, did it on the 40 watt, and then we're going to go down here, and we're going to take out the tray, there's the tray, and there's the wire, and you see wire on back side, this side up. So, what you're going to do is you're going to raise the tray, come in from the bottom, slide it in like that, and let it fall. And now you've got a tray extension, so that when you stick it back in the machine, it'll hang out. I want to stick it back in the machine just a second. Okay, so there's what it looks like installed. You can just pull it out. Push it in. Depending on your machine, the one on my 20 watt will slide in and out easier. This is a 40 watt machine. It hasn't been broken in very good yet, so it's still a little tough to do, but you get the idea. She pulls out, and then you can push her back in. No more trying to find that handle underneath there.